The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When the day came for them to be purified as laid down by the law of Moses, the parents of Jesus took him up to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord, observing what stands written in the law of the Lord. Every firstborn male must be consecrated to the Lord, and also to offer in sacrifice in accordance with what is said in the law of the Lord, a pair of turtle doves or two young pigeons. Now in Jerusalem there was a man called Simon. He was an upright and devout man. He looked forward to Israel's comforting, and the Holy Spirit rested on him. It had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he would not see death until he had set eyes on the Christ of the Lord. Prompted by the Spirit, he came to the temple, and when the parents brought in the child Jesus to do for him what the law required, he took him into his arms and blessed God, and he said, "Now, Master, you can let your servant go in peace, just as you promised, because my eyes have seen the salvation which you have prepared for all the nations to see, a light to enlighten the pagans and the glory of your people Israel." As the child's father and mother stood there wondering at the things that were being said about him, Simon blessed them and said to Mary, his mother, "You see this child. He is destined for the fall and for the rising of many in Israel, destined to be a sign that is rejected, and a sword will pierce your own soul too, so that the secret thoughts of many may be laid bare." This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
In today's Gospel, we read Simon's prayer, saying, "Master, now you are dismissing your servant in peace." He was able to say so because he experienced Jesus as his true peace. Simon received a great blessing to hold Jesus closer to his heart after a long time's prayerful waiting. The word of God says, Simon took him in his arms and praised God, saying, "Master, now you are dismissing your servant in peace, for my eyes have seen salvation." Chapter 2, verse 28 to 29. All our prayers and God experiences ultimately give us peace. When Simon says, "Dismiss your servant in peace," it means peace is an experience of Jesus residing and reigning in our hearts. Because Jesus is the peace. St. Paul says, He is our peace. Luke 2, chapter 14. Chapter 2, verse 14. We have to experience Jesus in the mode of peace. This experience is the unfailing sign of the presence of God. Our spiritual life should ultimately lead us to peace. All the fruits of the Holy Spirit are the character of Jesus. So also love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, generosity, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control are the character of Jesus. Holy Spirit is the one who pours into our hearts these fruits, which are the character of Jesus. Through baptism, Jesus comes to live in our hearts. The day Joseph and Mary presents Jesus in the temple of Jerusalem. The true temple of God is our own hearts. So, Holy Mother presents the church and through the sacrament of baptism presents Jesus into our own hearts. The aging Simon teaches that to experience Jesus is to experience His peace. Do we truly experience peace in our lives? If we have truly experienced Jesus in our lives, whatever our situation be, our inner being will be at peace. Simon prophesies to Mary that a sword will pass through her soul too, but Mary, in all circumstances, experienced the peace and joy. That is something we need to practice in our own lives. We cannot separate Jesus and peace. We cannot separate Christ from His character. Some people wrongly believe that to have no problems is to have peace. And that is reason why many cannot experience peace. For very many people who are engrossed in the troubles and problems of life very often tend to think peace can be experienced only after all these problems are solved and settled. For example, a sick person would say, sickness is the cause of my lack of peace in my life. I will have peace only when I will be healed. The jobless will say, I have peace only when I get a job. The homeless will say, I will have peace only when I get my own house. Those who are facing financial difficulty may certainly say, I can be peaceful only when my financial problems are settled. They think that peace comes through solving these problems. They have a wrong idea engraved in their heart that the way to peace is a life without problems. The truth is that such a thought is the root cause of lack of peace, because they think that peace is a state of mind When all the questions are answered and the problems are solved, we must realize problems are part and parcel of life. As long as we live in this world, we will have troubles and continue to have problems. Therefore, to think of a life in peace without problems would remain as a mere dream only. I remember a story of a fisherman and his family. The head of the family was an excellent fisherman. However, as he was getting old, he could not go for fishing anymore. He told his son, who was almost 18 years, "I am not healthy enough to go for fishing in the sea. Therefore, you may go for fishing and earn for the livelihood." The son took the blessing of his father as per his command, and under obedience, he went early morning with his boat for fishing in the sea. The father was waiting eagerly and anxiously for the son. It became evening. The son has not returned. It was almost night. The son was not yet back home. Somehow, he waited for him next day morning. Still, the son was not back home. It increased the heartbeat of the father due to the fear and anxiety. He sighed to himself, "What happened to my son?" With all the pain and stress, he decided to go the seashore to look for the son. He reached there thinking that something would have happened to the son. But to his surprise, he saw the son still sitting in the boat idle. The father asked, "My son, why have you not yet gone for fishing? Why have you not yet cast the net into the sea? Why are you still waiting?" The son replied, "Dad, I was waiting to see the waves to be calm to go for fishing." His dad said to him, "It is the nature of the sea to have waves in it, and it is quite natural the waves to roar against the shore. You will never be able to go for fishing after the waves to be still and calm. Neither you need not try to calm the waves of the sea. You just take care the boat from drowning due to hole and leakage. The problems are part of life and common to all in the world. It is impossible to begin fishing after all these getting settled." He said to the son, "You can never calm down the current and waves of the sea, but you can guide and calm yourself." Similarly, we have to realize we have no authority over anything around us and any problem around us. We have authority only on ourselves. Nothing shall shake our serenity and peace. There is a beautiful prayer by the Spanish mystic and doctor of the church, Saint Teresa of Avila. "Let nothing disturb you, nothing frighten you. All things are passing, God is unchanging. patience gains all. Nothing is lacking to those who have God. God alone is sufficient. This is to say that we shall not be disturbed by any situations around us and find peace depending on the circumstances. God alone is our peace, and He alone can bring peace in our lives. St. Francis of Assisi has a beautiful prayer: God grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, courage to change the things I can, and wisdom to know the difference. Living one day at a time, enjoying one moment at a time, accepting hardships as the pathway to peace, taking, as He did, this sinful world as it is, not as I would have it. Trusting that He will make things right if I surrender to His will, so that I may be reasonably happy in this life and supremely happy with Him forever and ever in the next. Amen. What are the things that I cannot change? We cannot change the nature and character of others. We cannot change what others think about us. Whoever it is up to me to think and what to say, these are deposited within me. Therefore, change needs not for others and situations. Change is needed for me and within me. We must ask to ourselves how I can keep my heart in peace and serenity. There the answer comes beyond the problems we face. Simon prophesies to Mary, the mother of Jesus, "A sword will pierce your own soul." Luke chapter 2 verse 35. Here one thing is clear. Simon is speaking about the sword after revealing the truth that peace is Jesus Himself. What does it mean? And what did he mean? Simon had meant to say, whatever may happen to you, whatever sword may pierce your heart, let Jesus be your peace. We conceive this great truth, we will have peace in the midst of any difficulties and disturbances. In the Gospel, we see a profound message repeatedly given by Jesus: do not be afraid. Let your hearts not be troubled. Do not be anxious. Let your hearts be not troubled. Neither let them be afraid. John chapter 14, verse 27. What does it mean by all this? According to Jesus, fear and anxiety are contrary to Christian life. Christian life means abiding in peace that cannot be deterred by anything in this world. Jesus has said, "Peace I leave with you, my peace I give you, I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not be afraid." John chapter 14, verse 27. Perhaps we might think, what does it actually mean by saying, do not be worried, anxious, and afraid? What is the meaning of it? We fail to understand the meaning of it as we fail to understand that peace is Jesus himself. Peace is the person of Jesus himself. Peace contains or exists in our relationship with Jesus. Because, as St. Paul said, he is our peace. Luke chapter 2, verse 14. This echo of this message can be found in the greetings of angels on the birth of Jesus. Instead of saying, Jesus is born, they were singing the glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth, peace among those whom he favors. Luke chapter 2, verse 14. Jesus was ascended into heaven by greeting peace to the disciples. As the risen Lord appeared to the disciples, he said to them, peace be with you. The disciples were overjoyed when they saw the Lord. The true peace and joy come from Jesus, as he is the source of peace and peace himself. St. Paul says that, now may the Lord of peace himself give you peace at all times and in every way. Second Thessalonians chapter 3, verse 16. Let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts. Colossians chapter 3, verse 15. This word of God unveils the great mystery and true meaning of peace to us. One day, a businessman, after having heavy loss in his business, tried all his level best to overcome the financial loss. He failed to pay back the debts and maintain his financial security. Therefore, he decided to sell his property except the house in which he lived. With the money he got from the selling of the property, he paid back all the debts incurred in his business and had the balance of a sum around 200,000 rupees. Then he had begun to be anxious, thinking about what is to be done with that money. He asked his wife, should I begin a business? His wife furiously said, you have already lost everything in the business, and thinking about another business is almost impossible. I am afraid we would lose even the existing house if you begin again the business. While being weighed down by the situation, one his friends introduced him to an agent to help him to get a job in the Gulf country. Since that moment, he began to be anxious and confused about whether he should go to Gulf country or should he begin to business. His wife advised him to go to meet any counselor who can properly discern the will of God. As he went to one such the counselor, after praying for him, replied, it is better to start the business. No need to go to Gulf. He shared it with his wife. However, the wife said, not proceed with business, as I have never heard about this brother. So she suggested to go to another counselor, and he found another and shared his situations. Then he said that no need to business, but go to Gulf. He was absolutely perplexed and confused. Finally, he went to attend a retreat to discern the will of God. The counselor during the counseling told him to start a business. At the end of the retreat, to confirm this message, he went to another counselor. He said, do not do business, but go to Gulf. After having utterly confused and not being able to make proper decision, finally he came to me seeking the prayers and advice. I told him about how to surrender these situations to the Lord. I told him, everything you have and yourself surrender to God. After such a prayer of surrender, the Lord will reveal to you and convince you that whatever you have and your own belong to the Lord. The Lord will teach you what to do in life. I prayed for him and asked him to praise God for a while and continues to pray by praising God. I asked him, how did he feel at that moment? He said, I feel inner peace. And I advised him to stay in the peace he experienced within himself. I continued meeting others. While opening the door, I found him to be outside the door once again. I asked, where are you here again? You did not tell me what to do with that 200,000 rupees. I asked him, didn't you hear properly what I had told you? He replied, yes, I did. I have to surrender all in the hands of God. I asked, you are not the 200,000 included in it? Then he asked me sarcastically, in reply to me with a disturbed heart, is it enough to sit and just praise without doing anything about the 200,000? I told him, peace is not something that you find with anything external. It is an inside business. I explained to him, when you are in peace, that is the time Holy Spirit is able to guide you to the plan of God for your life. When your mind is at peace, all the blessings in the universe will get attracted to you. That means when Jesus is in our hearts, then our heart will be like a magnet that attracts blessings. When your mind is disturbed, then all the problems in this world will get attracted to you. That is why we have some people say, I think I have all the problems that are there in this universe. A peaceful mind is ruled by Jesus. And so the kingdom of God is rightly called kingdom of righteousness, peace and joy. We do not have any authority over any situation of our lives. We do not have any control over what people around us should think, what they should say or what they should do. We need to understand we cannot change anyone or any situation. The only person we can change is ourselves. We can control what we should think, what we should say, what we should do. We can bring ourselves into the peace of Christ by completely surrendering ourselves to the authority of Christ. By surrendering ourselves completely into the hands of God, by accepting Jesus as the true owner of our lives, we can come into the peace of Christ. We belong to Christ and He is the Lord of our lives. And we trust in Him, and this is how we experience His peace. Dear sisters and brothers, today's gospel reveals an encounter of Simon with Jesus, his resultant experience of peace through Jesus. Peace is not something that comes from what we have. True peace comes from Jesus and through our intimate relationship with him. Therefore, let us hand over our life, all our painful and sorrowful experiences, to Jesus. Let us hand over all our financial difficulties and family problems to Jesus. Let us hand over all surrender to Jesus all our sickness, sufferings, personal problems and failures to Jesus. When Jesus walks into our life, there is peace. When we walk into the life of Jesus, there will be peace.